upstream is in a period of rapid growth with ambitious plans for the future. Where will the next phase of growth come from, and what does the pipeline look like?
So our current pipeline is very focused on expanding our presence in our existing markets. Mainstream is structured on a platform approach, so our platforms being Asia Pacific, Latin America, Africa, and global offshore. Clearly, global offshore is where we see a huge amount of potential and growth for the future. We're very excited to be here at the Global Offshore Conference here in London this week. Our equal ambitions for growth are focused around the Asian market. We see tremendous opportunities. We are very much an emerging growth markets player. So, you know, we go into countries where we see a huge amount of potential for the future. And our focus is very much on expanding our existing pipeline in Asia and growing it very ambitiously over the future.
So, and how do you go about assessing commercial risk in those nascent markets? Is there a standard template, or is it more of a case by case?
It's quite case by case, but you know, clearly we have, I suppose, a standard approach, I would say, rather than a template. We take quite a long term view. We are a development company at our core. That's our DNA. We're very entrepreneurial and innovative. So, you know, we look at the fundamentals of a market, where we see potential for growth over, you know, the short, medium and longer term. And in often cases, we would take a long-term view. For instance, we entered the Chilean market and the South African market both about 10 years ago now, when there really wasn't an established renewable energy market there at all. We were there from the outset. We took a long-term view of both because we could see the potential for renewable energy. And we've now grown to be the largest independent renewable energy player in Chile and the second largest in South Africa. And clearly both markets are very good examples of how a very strong renewable energy industry has developed over that time frame.
Absolutely. There's a growing recognition of a gender diversity issue in the STEM workforce. What specific measures have you observed in your career that have helped women to thrive in STEM-related careers?
It's such an interesting question because it's a topic very close to our hearts at the moment, I would say. Like within mainstream, we have been quite focused on addressing the gender disparity in very specific ways. For example, you know, we have an in-house mentoring program. We're very much fostering the next generation of women to establish their STEM careers and to be positioned very strongly for leadership. We are very pleased to be involved in the GWEC Women in Wind initiative. We're one of the sponsors of the program. I'm a mentor. One of my colleagues in South Africa is a mentee. And we are very excited by it being such a structured global program with very specific goals and targets over the time frame, and we're really pleased to play a part in that. You know, clearly the improvements in gender balance, really we would see as bringing a huge amount of advantages to our industry, to our organization, if I bring it back to mainstream's perspective. You know, encouraging a broader range of opinions, of experiences, of approaches as to how we work. You know, we see clear improvements in teams, in our approach to challenges, and you know, we're very much looking forward to seeing much improvements, hopefully, in the industry over the coming time frame.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.